Hello everybody and welcome back to part 4 of Pokemon Heart Gold KaosLocke. Remember, if you like this video or if you like any of my other videos, hit that like button and hit that subscribe button. Now, we're in the same place we were last time, but obviously here we have a new Pokemon. Last episode, tough stuff, our Illibuff went down, and we now have, that didn't tell me that earlier, Numel. Frosty, who's ice and normal, seems more to be a special attacker, but it has physical attacking moves. We have Chomper, the dark Kranidos with Drizzle, who got up to level 6, learned Fake Tears, and Alakazam, Magic Man, who is a fire type with Normalize, meaning all of his attacks are essentially normal, but can burn. And we battled some of the trainers up here. We caught Numel Frosty in the dark cave. Now, I don't know what type Psyduck is. It can't get going because of a slow start. That's nice to know. So let's try to use Icicle Spear. That is a bit. That is quite a bit for. Okay, hit 2 times. Psyduck must be a dark type, but that's. Well, 3 damage. Not bad. For slow start, I guess he would have done 6 without it. I don't know, but we're gonna try to get Frosty and Chomper up some levels. And we're gonna try to make some progress. Okay, we got a Grandle here. You know, instead of it being normal type, okay, that's not good. Not good, not good, not good, not good, not good. Frosty pulls through with 1 HP. What a way to start off an episode. So, oh man. Okay, we're gonna go to Chomper. I do not need to lose a Pokemon to a wild Pokemon. Grandbull uses Steel Wing with the crazy wings that it has. We're just gonna hit it with an Assurance. And then hit it with another Assurance. Might be not very effective, but it's still best bet we have, considering Alakazam's fire type attacks are actually normal. And that actually almost, well, that made us lose tough stuff in the last episode due to fighting a ghost type Licky Licky. I should use a potion on Frosty, because at 1 HP, if I can't run from something for whatever reason, then she would have died. Okay, so we battled this trainer. We got up to here. We got to Route 31, where we ran into a Groudon that we killed. Now, this guy's going to want to battle. No, this trainer right here is going to want to battle, though. At least he didn't say he caught a bunch of bug Pokemon, because then he'd probably be lying. Clerk Jasmine. This is the second Jasmine we've gone up against, I believe. Okay, so we're gonna go with Icicle Spear. I think Avalanche makes us go second. Okay, Icicle Spear's not doing damage. Not very effective. Okay. Used Astonish. That doesn't affect us because we're part normal. Which is helpful. The Avalanche is not very effective. Well, ice types are not very effective. But I still want to get. Okay, withdrew Poochyena. Okay. Going out to a Pelipper. Normally water flying. We're going to see what this does. Again, not very effective. So we're going to switch out. We're going to go to Magic Man. Pelipper uses Crab Hammer. Okay, that's fine. use that normal flame wheel. And okay, we got a hoot hoot. Let's just keep Magic Man in. Alex Am's gonna like dominate so far. Okay, well, of course it's not going to be super effective, but at least we know that Hoot Hoot's not rock or steel. Because then it would be not very effective. Take out the Poochyena. That's got to be some kind of... Well, I don't know. Because ice wouldn't be not very effective against... Ghost type, but it had Astonish. So we're just gonna let the rain go. And we're gonna use Assurance. Hope that does. Okay, not enough Ice Beam. An Ice type Tangrowth. At least it's not a Water type getting benefited from the rain. Tangrowth goes down. We got, you know, we did not learn anything from that fight, really. Oh, we're not getting your number. I don't want your number. I'm not shy. I just don't want your number. Iron Plate. Well, that'll be useful if we get an Arceus that happens to be a steel type or something. I don't know how. Okay, probably Groudon. We already ran into Groudon last time. Ooh, Rayquaza. That would have been nice. Frosty's in here. You know, okay, can't escape. Rayquaza's got Pin Missile. And Frosty's gonna die. Okay. There's our second Pokemon gone. That's nice. Fourth episode in, and we've already lost two Pokemon. And here's Lyra. She gives us the Versus Recorder. Not something we're going to need. So, well, this episode's kind of turned out a little crappy with the whole Frosty dying, but I do believe we can catch another Pokemon below Violet City, if I do remember correctly. In Heart Gold, Soul Silver, they allowed you to go below No, Frosty's not feeling better. Frosty's dead. Unfortunately. Okay, I hope this gets fixed by leaving. If I can get out. Fix? Okay, good. I know that the DS games have some minor graphical issues, but we can go down here. This should be a new route. I didn't see anything pop up. Is this still considered Violet City? I'm going to assume it's a different route. Let's see what we can get. I need Pokeballs! But oh, okay, a Sceptile. Hopefully not a Water-type Sceptile. We're gonna see what Thief does. Not very effective. And Sceptile has Roar of Time. Okay. That does quite a bit to me. So we're gonna switch out to Magic Man. Sceptile must recharge. And we go for the Fire Spin that hopefully doesn't kill. No, it doesn't do anything. And it also has Mirror Shot, which does nothing to us. Rain's gonna fall. We're gonna hopefully bring Sceptile into yellow. Nope. Okay, now Sceptile's in yellow. Goes for the Roar of Time. A Mirror Shot didn't really do anything, so hopefully, yeah. Not much at all. These videos just seem to take a lot longer, and I'm not liking it. Okay. I'm especially using Chomper and getting the rain. I gotta use Fire Spin at least one more time. I gotta get this thing into red. Okay, that did a lot more for whatever reason. So we're gonna hopefully Mirror Shot lowers our accuracy, but we're not gonna try to attack anymore. That shouldn't kill. There's no reason that Sceptile should at least live one more Fire Spin. Vortex being trapped in. Two, three. Sceptile's caught. We caught what I'm assuming is the steel type Sceptile. Now we just got a Dragon Steel. Okay. Dragon Steel. So it's essentially Dialga, especially with having Roar of Time. Don't worry, I'm not naming it. Dragonzord. Pokemon, not Pokemon. It's obviously not Pokemon. Okay, that's a route. I don't know what route it is. I really hope that some of these routes aren't, like, connected, and I don't know. Oh, crap. Okay, I am back. Apparently the ROM decided to just crash and not register my save, so I had to come all the way back from Violet, or from whatever town, I don't even know, Cherry, I don't know, I don't care. Get all the way back here and re-catch Sceptile. Sceptile's Steel Dragon. It has Motor Drive, raises the speed of hit by an electric type move, which is nice. It has Bullet Punch, Metal Burst, Roar of Time, and Mirror Shot. I kept thinking Roar of Time was a Steel type move, but it's a Dragon type move. Let's put Dragonzord, the Sceptile, up front. What I did was I just didn't catch the Numel. Didn't even go to the Dark Cave. Just said forget it. I guess technically we can get another encounter in Sprout Tower, though. I didn't catch the Numel. I didn't let Igglybuff faint. I just went. Okay, so Porygon. Porygon's not all that great. I'm gonna go with the Bullet Punch. Okay, super effective. Don't get to even find out what Porygon's type is. Porygon just dies. So that's unfortunate, but Dragonzord gets a level, which is nice, and we can start Sprout Tower. It's taken me a lot longer to get this far than I want to because of the crashing, but we'll just see what we can do. I didn't even check Dragonzord's like actual stats. Brick Break is not nice. But Bullet Punch is going to be very nice. Still, I believe this Sceptile is going to prove to be very useful. Now if I can just find out what Pokemon are actually electric type so I can switch it in. We're definitely not learning Takedown. Raichu, well, it could be an electric type, but most likely is not an electric type. So let's just bullet punch away. Okay, Brave Bird. Flying type Raichu. Because I'm Steel and Dragon, it's not very effective. We'll hit Raichu with the Bullet Punch. Take him out and get to level 7, I'm thinking. Pretty close to level 8. Cresselia. Let's just keep battling. I want to say this thing's not really going to be able to do much to me. I don't know what it can do, because I don't know what its type. I don't know anything about it. Double Slap. Not going to do anything. Even if it gets all 5 turns, I'm only down to 10. And the Bullet Punch will take Cresselia out, and I'll be level 8. This Cresselia is probably going to give me quite a bit of experience. Getting me probably very close to level 9, if not level 9. Level 9, okay. So, that's going to be it for now. I'm going to switch up Chomper to the front, because that one battle got Dragon's Orb quite a bit of experience. We're going to come in here and use a potion real quick, though. Just so next episode we're ready. And next time we will continue to take on Sprout Tower. Hopefully we can speed things up in the future. Bye.